How do you compliment Quinn Hughes? What are you doing to provide team defense? How are you helping your goaltenders out? This is an area that I don't know. For me to hear it's going to be by committee makes me feel like there's no specialty guys here. Mm-hmm. All right, who's the guy? Like, what that guy's job is to play good, sound, hard-nosed defense. That guy's job is to be a puck-moving guy. Or, you know, how are these all working together? It's almost like, well, we don't know who's going to play with who, but right, we'll figure it out along the way. And so then I started looking into the last game, 4-3. And it, yeah, I was concerned. I was a little concerned. We'll get to it here. The things I want to see is team defense. Let's give specific jobs. Scotty Stevens would love this right now if he was here to talk about it. Let's box out. Let's make sure the other team does not get second chance opportunities. Our goalie makes a save, then that should be enough, right? Like, we should not allow the second, third chance. There was a ton of second, third chances, like I mentioned. Casey Smith had to come through in a big way. And these are some of the things I'm talking about. And you're just going to watch the Edmonton Oilers. Pause it right here. So, actually, go a little forward. So, you're going to get a puck win, a puck battle as we roll this forward a little bit. And pause it right now. So Leon Draisaitl's going to get the puck, right? He's got the puck down there. And this is the part of it, like, everyone just, I think everyone's trying to help out, right? The instincts are like, I want to help out. But helping out isn't attracting everybody to one guy. Like, there's someone wide open in front of the net. And then you're going to roll this thing forward. And this is some of the stuff that Casey DeSmith had to see. And he makes a big save. Pause here. Bring it back a little bit further, because you have Zach Hyman going to the net. So keep going backwards, please. Keep going. Stop it here. All right, so this is the first picture that we saw with the in the middle of the ice. So now you got Zach Hyman, who's right here. Like, someone's got to get in between him and the net. No one does that. So roll it forward. It's going to go in front. You're going to have DeSmith make the first save. Zach Hyman's going to come in here unattested, and he's going to be able to take a swipe. Mm-hmm. So this is chance two. It rolls off his stick, fortunately, for the Vancouver Canucks. But then it just seemed like a lot of times in this game it was just an absolute free-for-all. I think sometimes it's about, just like in basketball, you got to box out once in a while. Pause it right here. So you've look what we're seeing in front of the net right now. We've got four Vancouver Canucks to the one Edmonton Oiler, okay? And we're going to roll this forward. Watch what this turns into. Everyone watching the puck, and just a free-for-all. Leon's going to get it here. He's going to take his stuff on it. Around that, pause it here. Everyone's watching the puck. Hyman gets another good look at it, another good crack. You've got Draisaitl on the backside. No one's boxing out. Like, get in front of somebody and force them out. Get in front, lift their stick and move them out like you would in basketball getting a rebound, right? Move this thing forward. And this is Casey Smith getting turned backwards, pucks in the slot. Like, it's just chaos. You rely on your goalie to make the first save. Second save, third save, he needs some help. And he didn't get much in this game. And we're going to look here. Terrible turnover. And it's going to go the other way. Pause it here. So you got three Edmonton Oilers going to the net, right? Like, and everyone's going to Leon. I get it. Leon garners a lot of attention, deservingly so. But roll it forward here. You're going to have nobody picking up anybody. Stop here. Like, come in here, lift a stick, get Connor McDavid, and move him out of the way. You know, move players out of the way. Look over your shoulder at who's trailing on the play. Keep it going forward. This is just another free-for-all. Casey DeSmith's rolling all over the ice. Connor McDavid, everyone's fishing for the puck. Just move Connor. You know, it's not Eric Lindros. And he's not going to overpower you and move you. Move him. And they didn't do it. So, and there's another one here where you've got Edmonton kind of coming into the play. And it's just too much puck watching, a strong take. And it's just, look at this crashing of the net. All these Oilers go in here, and everyone from Vancouver's puck watching. You know what I mean? It's just, that's an area, and I get it. They won. And we see, this is the part I don't want to get lost here. You're 2-0. So if you're Rick Tocchet and company, you're in the room. We're 2-0, guys. There's no time for panic. This is good. We're in a good spot. But we got to be a lot better. Like, you can't do that to your goaltenders and expect to win on a consistent basis. I can't expect Casey DeSmith or Thatcher Demko to play all world every game, or Brock Besser to get four goals every game. That area, they got to clean up a lot.
Yeah, I agree. And to the video that you were showing, is a lot of those second and third chances are coming by way of a lot of the elite players on the other team.
Yeah.
So now you're feeding it. You're feeding them. It's not, they're not getting what they earned per se.
Right.
You're kind of gifting them. Here's another shot for you, Connor. Leon, here's another one for you. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, all three of those guys had over 100 points last year. What are we doing?
It's not a recipe for success.
It's not a recipe for sustained success. So, look, I like the fact that there's desperation and guys are battling and it's a little street hockey, as you see here. No question. So Rick talking to the staff, they're going to respect the fact that the guys are battling hard. However, you got to make it easy on yourself because you're tempting fate. As mentioned, a lot of those grade A chances go to the best players in the opposition.
Yeah.
So you don't want to be giving them extra looks. That's the key.
And I think the thing too is, and they're working hard. It's chaos. It's a yard sale in front of the net. Bodies are flying everywhere. And I love this sacrifice. But work smart.
Yeah.
And working smart is player over here shooting the puck. Let me locate who's around and who's a threat over here. Let them do that. I will get you, lift your stick so you can't score, and I'll try to keep you away from my goaltender. Everyone's trying to do too much puck watching, and it's just an absolute free-for-all. So the fact they're 2-0, I love. I want to see them. They've got a ton of talent on that team. We see. I don't know if this team's any different. So I think we need to phone a friend. And this is a segment we have on the show. Well, we don't have the answers.
Yeah.
We got to phone a friend to make it to the next level of the competition.
What friend are we phoning?
That sounds like an old school landline.
This is my smartest friend I have.
That sounds like a landline, bro.
Smartest friend I have. He'll have
that's
the answer.
That's not a cell. That's a landline.
Hope he answers. Hey!
Oh, there he is.
Oh.
Mike Callie. Michael. Oh, just working out? Catching a little workout?
Sorry. Not just the smartest friend you have.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Why not?
Hey, you're going to be the smartest and strongest friend I have. But let me... So, Kels, we just got done talking Vancouver. Two games. We don't want to have a knee-jerk reaction. They're 2-0, but I didn't love what I saw from them in some areas. What are you seeing from the first two games?
Yeah, Rupper, a lot of what you're seeing too, and I'll get into some specifics here, but you got a really good eye, and I think you touched on a lot of really good points. The positives for the Canucks, look, like you said, they won two games. They had a bad start last year. You can't get off to a better start than winning two games against Edmonton. And they were opportunistic in transition. They had a lot of good offense going up the ice quick and capitalizing, scoring goals as well. Like we know, like for them, and this historically the last few years hasn't been a team that's had a great transition game. They were a lot better when Bruce Boudreau took over for a little while. They were better at parts of last season, but they did a good job getting up the ice. That greasy saucer pass right there by Elias Pettersson, unbelievable. And this was a huge goal here also. So opportunistic, that was good. They were getting good results off the rush against an Edmonton team that's got a really dangerous rush attack. Pettersson, Miller, Hughes, the big guys have been unreal. The power play has been great from a process and a results standpoint. So that's all positive for sure. And I think that's what Canucks fans so far, goaltending too, you guys talked about. That's a lot of good things happening at once. But like you said, it hasn't been perfect.
So where do you think this goes from here? Like, we're sitting there, I'm trying to think like in that locker room. And I think when you watch the tape, because you're right, and I didn't touch on those things. So I want to give credit where credit's due. Their power play is league lead right now after a couple games. They're generating stuff. They're getting the results. They're scoring goals, which we know this team should do. But on the same note, like, I feel like it's going to rear its head of what they were. Have they fixed those things? Like, I guess that's TBD, but, up to this point here, I mean, how do you see this team? You think they're going to push for a playoff spot this year?
Look, I still got them on the outside looking in. And competitive team, sure, of course, but you touched on some things with the defensive play, and that's exactly where I go is the defensive play. I don't like their bottom 4D at all. And let's just look at 5-on-5 in those two games against Edmonton. The zone time, there was a big, big difference. And Vancouver beat the wheels off the Oilers in the first game. But even though Edmonton lost the second one, like you said, it was pretty tilted. The good thing here is that the shot quality, those slot shots, even though Vancouver got outshot, a little bit in their favor. But you look at the fact that they outscored Edmonton 8-1 at 5-on-5. The rest of those process-related numbers don't back up that big of a differential, which is what happens in small sample sizes, is why things get a little squirrely at the start of the season. But your video was a great breakdown on some of the defensive issues that have haunted this team for a while. Like, I look at their defense. You got Quinn Hughes. He's an elite number one. Hronek's a really good defenseman, probably on a great team. He's on your second pair. The rest of those guys are third pair and defensemen to me. That's going to be the thing that I think as we get a bigger sample, we start to see potentially holding this team back. And Demko, he's got the ability to be great and steal wins and steal games, and he might. But I still think after two games, this team, my opinion is the same as it was before the season. They're going to have to scratch and claw and have some things go their way.
All right. Well, we appreciate you hopping on, Kels. I don't know if we got an answer. You know, I mean, because you got me leaning more towards they're doing more good things than what I'm seeing. But yeah, I think to your point, we got to see more.